I want to welcome and thank Sharon Lempner for being here. You'll be happy to see and meet Sharon. If you don't know her, she has been working with us in our Panera Bread Ministry ever since last year during the pandemic. So we're happy that Sharon is joining us. And also thank you to Serena for our children's message today. A couple of quick announcements. I wanted to give you an update on the final totals for the garage sale. We're so excited about it, we are. We collected all the money that was owed us, and we got $2,800. So thank you. And we received an extra donation for the bake sale, and from last week's sales, we ended up with $629 for the bake sale. So thank you for that. And the thrift shop was $303, which did stay the same because they were not open. So thank you to everyone who helped or participated in the garage sale in any way. We'd be happy also to know that all of the leftover treasures have been picked up by Volunteers of America, so they are cleared out of Pilgrim Hall. I am asking for just a couple of strong, or more than 1 week, I will take you just to move a couple of the tables so we can set up the hall. Our AA groups are coming back this week, and just to set up a few chairs for them. I promise I won't work you too hard. I tried to do it myself, but it was a very bad idea. So after church, if you could just meet us in Pilgrim Hall, couple of tables need moving, and then setting up some chairs. We really, really appreciate it. Just a quick reminder, next week we will celebrate the sacrament of Holy Communion, so we hope that you will join us next week on the 8th of August. Does anyone else have any announcements? Oh, Ken, I'll call on you first and then Linda.
Yes, our last concert of the season will be next Friday, and it will be in front of the middle school, and if it should rain, we're going to go in the middle school auditoriums. One way or another, it will be by the middle school.
August 6th. Now, I have 7:30 in the bulletin. Is that correct?
7:30.
7:30, August 6th, yeah. The Strongsville Community Band.
This is going to be a special tribute. We're calling it a tribute to the hometown heroes. So we'll be honoring our police department, fire department, school teachers, healthcare workers. We even got the mayor to come and sing God Bless America. So anyways, we're...
Well, that's worth seeing.
Yeah. He's been auditioned.
All right, I know you would not let anything happen there. Linda Key.
Question, when will we be doing the pennies coming out? Next time you...
The Sunday School, they're talking about Penny Sunday, probably near the end of August or maybe on Rally Day. I don't have information on that. But if you are anxious for Penny Day, Penny Sunday, keep holding on to those pennies, coins, and dollars. We will be doing that soon. Thanks for asking. Does anyone else have any announcements today? Seeing none, we'll continue with our worship.
Thank you. with verse 31. When the Son of Man comes in his glory and all the angels with him, he will sit on his glorious throne. All the nations will be gathered before him. He will separate the people one from another as a shepherd separates the sheep from the goats. He will put the sheep on his right and the goats on his left. Then the king will say to those on his right, "Come, you who are blessed by my Father, take your inheritance, the kingdom prepared for you since the creation of the world. For when I was hungry, you gave me something to eat. I was thirsty, and you gave me something to drink. I was a stranger, and you invited me in. I needed clothes, and you clothed me. I was sick, and you looked after me. I was in prison, and you came to visit me." The word of God for us, the people of God.
Thanks be to God.
At this time, before we come together in prayer, does anyone have any joys or concerns they'd like to share before the congregation? Serena.
My son's girlfriend's mother, they went on vacation, and on their way home, she ended up getting transported from a bus stop to a hospital. She has COPD and diabetes, but I'd like prayers for her because she now has pneumonia and sepsis in her lungs.
Oh, that's horrible. So terrible health issues. What's her name?
Deb.
A woman named Deb, who is the mother of Kenny's girlfriend, right? And she had a terrible incident and fell ill at a rest stop and had to be transported from a rest stop. First of all, a rest stop, and then to the hospital. So prayers for Deb. Anybody else? Laura Rock in the back.
I pray for two friends with health issues.
Kathy, and what was the other one?
Wendy.
And Wendy, with health issues. Sharon M.?
I have an update on my daughter, Lisa. She did wake up, but she's still not good. She's on dialysis still, and she has other issues going on. She has COPD, now she has sepsis. So she talks a little, but it's not making much sense, and that's where we stand.
An update on her cousin Lisa, who is still having health issues with COPD and sepsis in her lungs. Judy P.
A friend's, her name is Linda. She took a fall going through the mail and broke arms, wrists, ribs, ankle.
Yes, Jan Meyer's sister-in-law fell and broke, well, name it, and it's broken. The whole list there. So prayers for Linda. Barbara T.
Prayers for my friend Kitty. She's had very, very bad time. She's supposed to move out of her house today, and the family is in help. There's no trip. It's just she needs prayers.
Prayers for her friend Kitty, who's having moving issues and people letting her down issues. All right, does anybody have a joy? I need some joys.
Yeah.
All right, Don, I'll pick you.
Thanks to Ken Mahalko and the Strongsville band for
that. Yes. Thanks to Ken Mahalko and the Strongsville community band. Judy.
My son, who lives in the Philippines and has been quarantined there for the last year and a half, and unemployed, has his first job back as an entertainer on a cruise ship for 5 months solid.
Oh, that's wonderful. Her son got a job on a cruise ship. Okay. Well, let's wish him extra prayers of joy and safety.
Yeah.
Right. And Christopher, CJ, what do you got?
I have a joy that I'm moving into my first year of middle school.
Going into middle school. Middle school is a joy, right, Tom Foley? Tom teaches middle school. Somebody else? John took.
Oh, yeah. Well, I have enjoyed you. I just met a beautiful lady today who's a longtime member. And on the 27th of August, Betty will be celebrating her 100th birthday. Three digits. Wow.
Thank you.
Thank you.
You're not supposed to tell a lady's age. Come on, Jessica. but it's a sensory.
Well, I should go dancing there.
Okay.
A joy that my brother and I will soon, by the end of this month, be moving out of our house and into a new area in Bria.
A joy that he and his twin brother are moving out of their parents' house. That is a joy for everyone. And to Bria.
Not the parents' house, just
oh,
the
just
house
moving.
We've been
right.
Leaving.
Well, I know you're staying with them. Okay, we're not going to go into that. All right. All right, and I'm not trying to diminish anyone. Does anyone have a concern also? Okay. All right, seeing none, we'll continue.
Lord Jesus, we just want to thank you for the testimonies where you've stood beside us, where you've given us long life. We ask, Lord Jesus, for the people that are in need of support, in our need of physical comfort, we ask, Lord Jesus, that we continue to be the help that they need, that we continue to pray for them, that we continue to lift them up, that we stand by their sides, and that we help them in this time of trouble. We just thank you that you've given us strength and health and long life. We ask that you bless all the children going back to school. These are still serious times, and for our young people, this is very important to live their lives and to be happy and to be with their friends. We ask that you lead them and guide them in school, give them peace in the middle school during a time of adolescence. Could you join me in the Lord's Prayer? Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts, as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen.
Thank you. Now it is time for the children's message. If all the children would like to make their way down. Today's lesson is about looking for ways we can help others. In doing so, we honor God. So I was wondering if you can answer some questions for me. Simple yes or no. Does God need a packed lunch every day? Does God need medicine for illness? Does God need hats and gloves? Thankfully, God does not. But there are a lot of people in need of these things and more. So where is God? God claims we see him when we feed the hungry, when we clothe the naked, when we care for the ill. We see God all around us. When we see those in need, when we help those in need, we are serving God. Can anybody tell me a way that they can serve God?
Giving a homeless person shelter or food.
That's a good one. Anybody else?
Doing volunteer work.
That's a good one too. God of the Bible is not always above us in the clouds, but rather surrounding us in the mysteries and wonders of the universe. As a neighbor, as a friend, as a stranger in need, we can serve God by loving and helping others. Let us pray. Lord, show us the simple things we can do to serve you through those all around us and in the world. Let your Spirit guide us when there are opportunities for us to devote our time, love, and care to help someone in need. Amen.
Congregation is truly blessed, aren't we? We have all these beautiful children. We have lots of folks sharing their talent to teach those children and their time away from our service. We have musicians sharing their talent to help provide beautiful music for us to enrich our service. And now we have the opportunity to share, to give back some of the treasures the Lord has provided with us, to us, so that we may do the work of our church. Will the ushers please serve us?
Thank you.
gifts upon the altar. Thank you for these gifts and the givers. Let them be done and used for your honor and glory. We love you in Jesus' name. Amen. Good morning, everyone.
Good morning.
Let the words of my mouth and the meditation of my heart be acceptable in thy sight, O Lord, my strength and my redeemer. I bring heartfelt thanks and greetings to the church in this sanctuary and to you watching online. Thank you to Pastor Heidi for the invitation to share with you God's mercy and testify to his love and care for the hungry, the thirsty, the stranger, the naked, the sick, and the imprisoned. As I am now closing in on 70 years of age, often I reflect on my long relationship with God. I am thankful for the seasons of growth and knowledge, and I'm repentant for the seasons of stagnation and rebellion. But thank God I'm here today to worship with you and celebrate the redemption through the cross of Jesus Christ. My relationship with the Strongsville United Church of Christ goes back about a decade. It started with your thrift store and my connection to Janice Justice Booth. The store was doing its biannual cleaning for seasonal product changes, and I was allowed to come and glean unneeded items for ministry. This went on sporadically over the 10 years. Now I fast forward from that very loose relationship with Strongsville United Church of Christ to the spring of 2020. Prior to the pandemic, churches worshiped and Christian ministries were reaching the lost and supporting discipleship efforts. But in March 2020, a shift occurred. The impact of that moment seems to have faded a bit now, and many have chosen to forget or deny that time altogether. But when I read my daily diary entries from last year, I'm brought back to an atmosphere of the unknown, the unprepared, and a sense of confused fear. This was not the first time human populations have been threatened with disease on a massive scale, but it was the first time for this generation. Recreation centers closed, entertainment and restaurants shut their doors, large gatherings were banned, churches went virtual, travel ended. And as we all know, haircuts and hair coloring stopped. We've seen some strange sights. Grocery stores and essential businesses eventually installed plexiglass screens, and shoppers began ordering online. Many people simply stayed at home. The elderly got very sick. Some were hospitalized, and some, unfortunately, are no longer with us. How did my husband and I cope month after month? Well, we sat at home. I moved my furniture around in the living room so I could look out the window into an unknown space. I cooked all the meals we ate. I read Dallas Willard and Richard Foster's books on spiritual discipline became my readings and ponderings. They taught me that spiritual discipline is not a magical road to a closer walk with God. No, they taught me not to center on the importance of knowing or doing the disciplines as I began applying the practices, the disciplines themselves were not the answer. They led to the answer. I learned that the focus was always on Christ. The disciplines I was making part of my daily life did not make me better in God's eyes. They only put me in a place where God could do his work through me. So now to the scripture from the 25th chapter of Matthew, where Jesus is teaching about the final judgment, starting in verse 37. Then the righteous will answer him, "Lord, when did we see you hungry and feed you? Or thirsty and give you something to drink? When did we see you a stranger and invite you in? Or needing clothes and clothe you? When did we see you sick or in prison and go visit you?" The king will reply, "Truly I tell you, whatever you did for one of the least of these brothers and sisters of mine, you did for me." In this passage, the Son of Man is upon the glorious throne surrounded by angels. Jesus uses the metaphor of a shepherd to explain the separation of the blessed from the cursed in the final judgment. In the reading from the Gospels, which Linda read, you heard Jesus invite the righteous to take their inheritance in the kingdom prepared for them. And he told them the reason why they would inherit the heavenly kingdom. Jesus told them that they had given him food, drink, clothes, and ministration. In fact, this conversation is duplicated in verses 41 to 46 with the cursed ones, who Jesus refers to as the goats. The righteous and the cursed are both asking Jesus for an explanation. Jesus tells this story of judgment twice in Matthew 25, once to the sheep and once to the goats. What I found odd is it is not the goats alone who are clueless. So are the sheep. Neither group felt that they had actually fed, clothed, visited, and offered drink to Jesus himself. Both groups standing in judgment admit to Jesus that they had not ministered to him. I could see the goats being confused, but the sheep too. Yet without even fully comprehending that they were doing God's will, they were doing it. They were doing God's will, and yet were somehow slightly unaware. So Jesus makes it clear. The way we treat the least of Jesus' brothers and sisters is the same as if we were doing it to Jesus himself. I think of the shock of the pandemic, the time we had for studying the Bible, the time in godly meditation, time of prayer, day after day. It opened us up to receiving the more of God's will. Even if we were not sure or confident in what we were doing, God had a plan. And his children would show him to others. They would show the love of God to the least of his brothers and sisters and let them know that he cares for them and wants them to trust in him alone. God used a web of alliances that had not even existed previously. He used children that were open to his will. In the spring of 2020, the homeless and sheltered communities in Cleveland were scrambling for solutions. along with the rest of us in this room, shelters held too many people to even allow for minimal safe distances. If you remember, masks were not to be found in stores or online. People were losing jobs. All communities were stressed. But when you add the stress that the need for food, drink, clothes, and shelter on top of the stress of the pandemic, we see fear, panic, despair, and escape behaviors rise. Many who were exiting the justice system and hoping to put the past behind them came to the community where there was no work and no income. Without a plan or a blueprint to address this unique and dangerous pandemic, our missions went to the shelters and tent communities weekly within 30 days of Ohio's shutdown order. Christians went out in homemade masks, gloves, and rubbing alcohol. Clothes were donated from everywhere, including Strongsville United Church of Christ. Around June, this church was seeking to find an outlet for the Panera donations that you had been using for your Wednesday community meals. Where we were unaware of God's plan, God was connecting those willing to do His will. He was using His church to showcase His love for everyone, even those to whom the pandemic had multiplied the hopelessness. But God knew their needs. He heard their prayers. His love and mercy are boundless. Without a meeting, and without a master plan or even a network, God put together your church body and our church body. He already knew we were all one body in Christ. Now, as of this past Friday, 108 bread distributions have left Strongsville United Church of Christ and ended up throughout the Cleveland area. Where? Here's a few examples. Low-income senior high-rises, group homes, St. Herman's House of Hospitality, homeless hotel shelters in Lakewood, the Men at 2100 Lakeside, run by the Lutheran Ministries, Antioch Baptist Church for Community Food Outreach Ministry, veterans in three sheltered communities, individual elderly living alone, tent communities, federally subsidized housing for women and children, and the Denison United Church of Christ. Those shelters on 99th and Denison. Okay, so that explained the where. Those are the buildings and locations, but it's the people served that God provided for. The reports have been so positive and the recipients so thankful. All we say in response to their appreciation is, just thank God. Not only was food distributed, but so were clothes, coats, blankets, and basic toiletries. These clothes were given out every week to the men sheltered at 2100 Lakeside, the tent communities, and women sheltered nearby during the height of the pandemic. Your clothes, blankets, shoes, socks, hats, and gloves out of this body of Christ have greatly blessed God's children. So let me, as I get ready to end, let me paint two brief pictures. We were doing a distribution of women's clothing outdoors on, I think it was 17th and Payne. So a woman came up to the table, and we sort of have the philosophy that we're not here to just hand you anything. We respect and honor your humanity. Choose the things you need. Choose the colors you like to wear. Choose the clothing that is your style.
So we have tables out, and we let people do their own shopping. Okay, a woman comes up to the table. She shopped, looked at the items we were offering, and she chose the items she liked, and one item was a pair of underwear. So she stepped away from the table, lifted her skirt, which I'm not going to do, pulled up the new underwear, thanked us, and left. She didn't have any underwear on prior to picking it up. Here's another example. It's winter. And remember, even though we're used to 9 o'clock now, it did get dark at 5 o'clock back in those cold months. Okay, we're coming to them, but let's not think about it. There was snow and slush all over the ground. We were distributing under a street lamp about 6 o'clock at 2100 Lakeside. So one man in line finally reaches the tables where the men can choose the things they need, and he was wearing flip-flops and no socks. So we're all sort of standing there. We don't make a big deal of standing there, but we did see his feet in the freezing slush. It was quite obvious. But so did God. We handed him warm socks and a pair of shoes that were his size. Both items had been donated. He sat right down in the snow and the slush and put them on. Another prayer answered. I'm going to say that the need is so great and it never ends. You've been here for 200 years. You know the needs. I'm not telling you something you don't know. Christians do give hope, and God does change lives. Let us, as a community of faith, not stand before God in judgment and say, when did we feed you, Jesus? When did we clothe you? When did we go to you and offer our best, as you taught us? No, let the righteous simply open our lives to do his will. Let us be consistent and faithful. Let us be thankful that God is using us when needs are met and food and clothing of clean, high quality are given. God teaches that he does stand by each and every person, always ready and willing to take them into his saving arms. In the bulletin, the title of this message is simply, Why? Well, when men and women come to us during these distributions, they often approach us and say, I need prayer. Then we know God is moving closer to a soul in need of salvation. This is God at work through us. This is why God is using us. This is why Christ rewards. Someone has come to him and asked for prayer. Someone is ready to surrender to him. Since Jesus cares, we who have his spirit also care. This is the why we do the things we do. It all centers on Jesus. It all centers on God. Thank you, workers in God's kingdom. Here at Strongsville United Church of Christ. May God continue to use you and bless you. As we leave this place of worship and fellowship today, I pray that we continue to draw closer to God, and when he comes to us in our quiet moments of prayer, we answer with the words, I will go, Lord, if you lead me. I will hold your people in my heart. God richly bless each and every one of you. Please stand for the singing of hymn 589.
Thank you.
Now may the peace of God, which is beyond all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and of his Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. Know that wherever you are, God is with you. Amen.
Amen.